In this video, you'll learn how payroll accountants determine federal tax withholdings using the percentage method. There are two methods, the wage bracket method, which I covered in the prior video, and the percentage method. I recommend that you first watch the prior video, which I linked above, about calculating tax using the wage bracket method, because it steps you through the initial concepts of pre-tax deductions and how to calculate taxable income for federal tax calculations. The wage bracket method is often preferred because it's easy to use. The second method for calculating federal income tax withholdings for employees when the employer uses manual payroll systems is the percentage method. Publication 15T, which we previously used for the wage bracket method, as well as your textbook, Appendix C, includes the percentage tables. The percentage method for calculating employee withholdings is tiered, with each layer building upon the previous layer. Kind of like a chocolate layer cake. The federal income tax is the sum of the taxes from each layer or tier. The computations in these tables were changed in 2021 to make them more consistent between the withholdings per pay period and the amount calculated on the annual tax return. So how's this method different from the wage bracket method? Well, it's more exact. The wage bracket table has bands, and within that band, each employee has the same dollar amount of federal income tax withholdings, even if the wage differs. That's not the case with the percentage table, because the calculation is based on the exact taxable wage of the employee. So the percentage method also allows more flexibility for calculations involving high wage earners or uncommon pay periods. But the wage bracket method is simpler for manual payroll tax calculations. And although the percentage method is more flexible, it's also more difficult to use and understand and requires additional calculations. This is what the percentage method table looks like. The first header line shows 2024 percentage method tables for manual payroll systems with forms W-4 from 2020 or later. Be sure that you're using the correct year. For this class, you need to use the 2024 percentage method tables. Next, double check that you're using the table for the correct payroll period. This table is for biweekly payroll periods. Next, the table splits into a left section for the standard withholding rates and the right side for the Form W-4 Step 2 checkbox withholdings. How do you know whether to use the standard withholding section or the Form W-4 Step 2 checkbox withholding section? The exercise or example will tell you if box 2 was checked, or in practice, when the employee hands in their Form W-4, the box in Step 2 will be checked. Then we have a section for each filing status. Here you can see married filing jointly, and below that, single or married filing separately. There's another section that is not shown on this page for head of household. So let's examine the headers and rows for the taxable income amounts. The first row in the married filing jointly section reads if the wage amount is at least zero, but less than $1,123, then the tentative amount to withhold is $0 plus 0% of the amount that exceeds $0. Well, that seems a little weird, right? But what it is telling you is that the tax is zero if your adjusted wage or taxable income is less than $1,123. So let's look at the next row. If the income is at least $1,123, but less than 2015, then the tentative amount is zero plus 10% of the wage amount above $1,123. So if the wage amount in a biweekly period was $2,014.99, then the tentative amount is zero plus 10% of the wage amount above 1,123, which is $891.99, so a tax amount of $89.20. What if the taxable wage amount is $4,749.99? For that amount, let's look at the third row where the amount is at least 2015 but less than $4,750. The tentative amount is $89.20, which is the tax amount from the prior tier, plus 12% of the amount above $2,015, which is $2,734.99 times 12%, or $328.20, plus the tentative amount of $89.20, for a total of $417.40. Now, if the employee has checkbox 2 checked, you would calculate the taxes on the right side. So if the wage amount is $4,749.99, then we would look at the fifth row where the wage is at least $4,428 but less than $7,944. The tentative amount is $660.30 plus 24% of the amount above $4,428, which is $320.99 times 24%, or $77.28. We add the tentative amount of $660.30 plus the $77.28 for a total amount of $737.58. Here's another example of an employee with dependents. Employee A is single, has two dependents under the age of 17, reported on her Form W-4 for 2024. He is paid semi-monthly and earns $92,400 per year. He does not receive any other income and does not itemize his deductions. Form W-4 Step 2 checkbox has not been checked and the employee has no pre-tax deductions. We start with a period wage of $92,400 and divide it by 24 because the employee is paid semi-monthly. That gives us a semi-monthly wage of $3,850. Employee A is single and did not check box 2 on the W-4. Therefore, we look on the left side on the table of the table in the section for single taxpayers. Please be sure that you have the tax table for the correct payroll period. In this case, semi-monthly. We find the right row that includes the semi-monthly wage of $3,850. We subtract $2,573 from $3,850, which is $1,277, and multiply it by 22% for a tax amount of $280.94, and then add the tentative amount of $226.12 for a total of $507.06. However, we still need to give employee A credit for having dependents. Each dependent under 17 is worth $2,000 in tax reductions per year. So please note that the $2,000 only applies to dependents under 17. For other dependents, we use the lower amount of $500. In this case, though, the dependents are under 17, and we divide the $4,000 by 24 because that is the number of pay periods for semi-monthly payroll, which gives us $166.67, which we subtract from the amount of $507.06, which then results in the final federal tax withholding of $340.39 per paycheck. Let's look at another example. In this case, employee B is married and has two dependents under the age of 17, reported on her Form W-4 from 2024. She's paid semi-monthly and earns $96,000 per year. She does not receive any other income and does not itemize her deductions. Form W-4 Step 2 box has been checked. Her spouse earned $49,000 per year. Employee B has no pre-tax deductions. So let's start off by dividing the annual wage of $96,000 by 24, which is $4,000. If the employee had any pre-tax deductions, we would deduct those now, but she doesn't have any. We then find the correct section of the percentage table for a married filing joint taxpayer who has checks step two of form W-4. The fourth row is what we need because it includes wages of $4,000. This row tells us that all taxable wages above $2,573 are taxed at 22% plus an amount of $226.12 for the amounts below $2,573. We subtract $2,573 from $4,000, which is $1,427, and multiply it by 22%, which results in $313.94. To that, we add the amount of $226.12 to get the preliminary taxes of $540.06. We then calculate the semi-monthly tax deduction for the two dependents, which is $166.67. We subtract that from the preliminary taxes and end up with $373.39. Please keep in mind that this tax amount cannot be negative. Therefore, if the dependent deduction is greater, then the preliminary taxes we enter zero as the final taxes. What is left to do is to calculate the additional taxes for the spouse's income. We do that by pulling up page 4 of Form W-4 and finding the intersection between the highest paying job of the spouses in the row section and the lowest paying job of the spouses in the column section. In our example, that is $6,090 per year. We divide that amount by 24 for $253.75 and add to it the net tax amount of $373.39 for the final tax amount of $627.14. I hope you enjoyed learning about the percentage method of manually calculating the federal income tax withholdings.